So now let's dive into the chemistry, but have some fun with the chemistry, because this is where it gets nuanced is an understatement. So you have phytocannabinoids in nature, CBDA, which we'll talk about tonight, which is different than CBD, THCA, there's 104 phytocannabinoids. They all do different things. Do we talk about omega fatty acids like they're all the same? No. There's omega 5 and omega 7, omega 9, omega 3, omega 6. There's arachidonic acid, dicosahexaenoic acid, icosapenta. There's a lot of them, right? They all do different things. They all have different structures. They all have different functions. So do the cannabinoids. Now listen closely. Your body also makes marijuana-like compounds. Your body makes marijuana-like compounds all day long, and most of us had no idea. Now you do feel the marijuana-like compounds if you do a lot of aerobic activity. So they say, oh, 20 minutes of aerobic activity, you start feeling really good. And you just kind of just moving around, trying to figure out, and all of a sudden you start feeling different. Why do you feel different? Has anyone ever had the runner's high when you cross the marathon and you cross that finish line and you're like, I'm high? What are you high on? Ready? Anandamide, which means bliss, joy, delight in Sanskrit. That's right, your body, my body, all of our bodies, we make the bliss neurotransmitter. And you feel complete bliss when you have exposed yourself to a lot of anandamide from a lot of aerobic activity, and you cross that finish line, you're high on your own supply. That's what God made. THC and CBD are biological coincidence. Nicotine receptor. Acetylcholine fits into it, but so does nicotine. Were you born to smoke Pall Mall cigarettes? Of course not, right? So we weren't born to have a relationship with cannabis. We weren't preordained to have a relationship with THC. No, not at all. Ready? Phytocannabinoids are neuro and immunomodulatory, as are the endocannabinoids. When you take the phytocannabinoids, they influence the endocannabinoids. So you're getting benefit from your own body and the compounds we produce, and we're fine-tuning it with the CBD oil that we're getting from hemp. Does that make sense to everybody? So these compounds have direct activity and indirect activity, because the phytocannabinoids influence the fate of the endocannabinoids. Now, if we look at CBD by itself, stop thinking of any other cannabinoid just for a moment. CBD is anti-inflammatory and analgesic and anti-diabetic and antibacterial and anti-cancer and anti-proliferative and anti-ischemic and spasmodic and neuroprotective and anti-epileptic and anxiolytic. This is a treasure trove. This is a complete and total cornucopia of healing. Now, for those of you that want the deep medical literature, there is tremendous material online right now. How many of you use PubMed.gov? Can I see a show of hands? Great, more in this group than in other groups. PubMed.gov. P like Paul, PubMed.gov. PubMed.gov is the National Institutes of Health's open access database.